Hi everyone, this lesson covers some of the most common transformation tasks that you will have to perform. I already opened a blank workbook and I'm going to insert a dataset with the total number of estimated new births during the given year. I took this dataset from gapminder.org. Let's go to Data tab. And from Get and Transform Data section, I'm going to click the button Get Data. Then from File, from Text/CSV, and find the file. Here is the preview of the dataset. Click on Transform Data. And here is our data set with 16 columns and 184 rows. Any transformation you make to your data will appear as a step in the Applied Steps area. Excel made two applied steps automatically, like use first row as headers and change the type of the last column to number. The first step is to take this ID column and move it to the left. So there it is first. There are some countries like Barbados that they don't have information at all. So if I wanted strictly to display data, one way I can do it is to filter this column so that if it's null, I don't want to select it. Press OK. And I've applied the filter. This will make sure that I don't have any data set that has basically no data in it. Now, all these year columns have values in. Notice that the data type of some columns is text. If I want to change the data type, I'm going to click on 1800, hold my Shift key down, and click on the last column. And select any type of data I want. In that case, I'll choose whole number. It's important to note that there are actually two kinds of blank values. Null and empty string. A null is essentially a numerical value of nothing, while an empty string is equivalent to entering two quotes in a cell. Blank fields are not necessarily a bad thing. But an excessive number of blanks in your data can lead to unexpected problems when it comes time to analyze your data. Suppose you want to replace only the null with zeros. Select all the year columns, right-click, and choose Replace Values. The key here is to enter the word null as the value to find value. You can then enter the value that you want to use instead. In this case, you can enter 0 as the replace with value. OK? And you notice it worked nicely. All my nulls have been changed to zeros. Now let's move to Transform tab. We have many features divided into 6 different sections. Table, any column, text column, number column, date and time column, and finally structured column. There are lots of numeric transformations from this number column section. First, we have statistical operations, like sum, average, or count values. These tools are applied to an entire selected column and return a single value. You will find them right here in the Transform menu. Let's switch to Add Column. And it's gray. We can't use them. They are transforming a column into a single value. For example, highlight year 2000 and select Sum. This is the total population of all countries for year 2000. Delete this step. If I select the country column and press again the statistics button, I can use only these two operations because it's text. Next up, we have standard mathematical options that perform basic math operations. Select the product ID, add column tab, standard button, click on multiply, type a random decimal number, for example 2.25, and OK. It creates a new column here at the end that multiplied each value of ID column with 2.25. If you have decimal numbers, then it's easy to round them up or down from this button. Select round up and move the column next to ID. Great! Let's take a look at the text column, like country, making sure that the text in your data has the correct capitalization may sound trivial, but it's important. Fortunately, Power Query has a few built-in functions that make changing the case of your text a snap. When I look at text, my text transformations are the things that we would normally rely on: lower or upper case, or add a prefix to the front of each value in the column. You can easily remove leading and trailing spaces by using the trim function in Power Query. If you look at country column, there are some countries that have space in front of text. Use the trim feature and it works nicely. Some of you may know that the trim function of Excel removes the leading spaces, trailing spaces, and excess spaces within the given text. Power Query's trim function removes leading and trailing spaces but doesn't touch the excess spaces within the text. If excess spaces are an issue in your data, you can deal with them by using the replace values function to replace a given number of spaces with just one space. In Excel, we have the benefit of the right function, the left function, and the mid function. These functions allow you to extract portions of a string starting from different positions. Power Query has equivalent functions, expose through the extract command, found on your transform tab. The options under the extract command are length, first characters, last characters, and so on. To extract the first three characters of text, highlight the column with countries, select extract, first characters, and then use the dialog box to specify the number of characters that you want to extract. Unlike undo in Excel itself, I can get rid of a step and lead the other steps around it. If I'm not sure what this step did, I can click the gears. Duplicate records are absolute analysis killers. It is for this reason that finding and removing duplicate records should be your first priority when you receive a new dataset. I have some duplicate records, like Bolivia. Note that having two records with the same value in a column does not necessarily mean you have a duplicate record. Once you have a clear idea of what field or column has duplicate records, you can highlight it, for example country, right-click, and remove duplicates. Now let's talk about this powerful feature, UnPivot, and I will show you how it works. Power Pivot offers an easy way to unpivot and pivot columns, allowing you to convert matrix-style tables to tabular data sets, and vice versa quickly. In this table, I want all the columns with years to be represented as rows. Let's choose the information that I want unpivoting. So highlight the columns from year 1800 to 2015. The unpivot doesn't change the first columns, ID, multiplication, and country. Click the unpivot button. So what I have now? I have rows and rows of data. Every single of these columns became a row. Rename this column to year. And this one to population. So we unpivot this data in order to provide a flat dataset rather than a summarization table. When transforming your data, you'll sometimes have to add your own columns to extract key data points, create new dimensions, or even create your own calculations. You start a new custom column by going to the Add Column tab and clicking the Custom Column command. This activates the Custom Column dialog box. The Custom Column dialog box is your workbench for adding your own functionality to your query through the use of Power Query formulas. Just as in Excel, a formula can be as simple as s equals to 1 or as complicated as an if statement that applies some conditional logic. But there are some high-level differences of which you should be aware. No cell references. Power Query formulas work by referencing columns, not cells. Excel functions don't work. Power Query has many of the same kinds of functions as Excel, but it has its own formula language. Everything is case sensitive. In Excel, you can type in all lowercase or all uppercase letters and formulas will work. Not so in Power Query. Data types matter. Excel does a good job at handling formulas that mix fields of differing data types. But the Power Query formula language is extremely sensitive to data types. Let's start with a simple custom column. Let's create a new column that merges the country and year columns. Place the cursor in the formula area after the equal sign. Find the country column in the available columns list and double-click it. After country, enter the following text. And double quotes at double quotes again, end. This text will ensure that the values in the two columns are separated by the word at. Next, find the year column in the available columns list and double-click it. Note the message at the bottom of the dialog box stating that no syntax error have been detected. Each time you create or adjust a formula, you will want to ensure that this message states that no errors have been detected. Click OK to apply your custom column. You have a new custom column that concatenates two fields. With this example, you get the basic foundation of how Power Query formulas work. At a later lesson, I will show you more complex functions. If you finished with the table transformation from Home tab, I can press the Close and Load button to apply the changes I've made. But make sure that you don't have any errors in your table. I'm going to choose Close and Load too. I want to load this right to the data model. And I'm right back here with my transform query. Thank you for watching.